Hi there, and thanks for joining me in another intro session to Codux. This time we'll be talking all about boards, what they are, how they can help you out, and how you can use them. So we're going to start by jumping into a quick demo project that I have already set up. And the first thing that greets you when you open up Codux on a project is the home screen. And this is where you actually see all of the boards in that project render. Now, what exactly is a board? A board is a fixture that allows you to set up a component in an isolated, encapsulated manner so that it could render on its own without interfering with any other part of your application. This is how you can work on smaller bits of code within Codux. Now, boards are just React components at the end of the day because they need to render the component that you want to be editing. But there can be primarily two different motivations for why we'll be creating a board. The first is to represent various states of a component, to verify that its behavior matches what we want to see. So if, for example, we'll take a look at this block component that we have, then we can see that we already have three boards set up for this component. If we take a look at the card, we'll see the same thing. So we have a card or a card with extra long text or a card that has a subtitle to it. And we can create all the different permutations of that component, including screen sizes, prompts, context providers, and so on and so on, just to make sure that it behaves the way we expect it to. Now, the other reason why we would use a board is actually to create variants of our components that we could then add to our application through Codux in an easy and simple manner. If we take a look at the icon button, we can see that I already have four boards already set up here for different props permutations. And then if I want, I could then later on use these fixtures, use these setups to add them into my component or whatever bit of code I'm working on. The next reasonable question is, how do we create a board? Well, there are several ways of doing so in Codux. The first of which is that whenever I create a new component through Codux, a board file will automatically be created for this new component as well, so that Codux already has a way of rendering it. If I want to create a board for a specific component that already exists, I can simply filter based on that component name and click New Board. This will create a board for that specific component. If I'm not seeing the specific component I'm looking for, perhaps because it doesn't have boards already, I can click this Scan Components button at the bottom left, and this will make all components available, and so I'll be able to create a brand new board for those as well. Now, if I want to, I can also create just a generic all-purpose kind of board, or a board that I'll decide later how to use, and in this I can put one component, many components, or even no components at all if I want it to serve as a pure HTML, static HTML sort of fixture. Now, how does one actually edit a board? It's very simple. If you want to change the properties or the structure of a board, you can simply select it, open it so that it renders on stage, and now you have the ability of selecting any element within that board, for example, our rendered credit card component. Once I do that, you'll immediately see on the properties panel over on the right all of the various properties that are currently being passed to that component. You can see the same thing being reflected in the code drawer. And if I were to change Mike Smith to Jane Smith, then that change is automatically reflected on stage and within the code. You can also see that this board is rendered within a div, and that div has some styling applied to it. It probably applies some padding, maybe colors the background, and so on. But Codux is not meant simply for editing boards. This is just our entry point into editing actual components. If I click on this pencil icon over here, or I can double click on stage or within the tree, that brings me to the inner scope. And you can see here that now I'm actually editing the credit card component. This is reflected both within our breadcrumbs on top of the stage here, and the elements panel now reflects this component. Any change I make here will now be reflected in the real component and in the production code. It's important to say that boards are not really production code. They're similar to tests. You would set them up as part of your dev environment for you to work better and to work in a more streamlined manner. But the fun of editing doesn't stop here. We can also control a bunch of other things when it comes to our board. If I go back to the board scope and I take a look at our last panel here over on the right side, this is the board settings panel. And here we can control a number of things. First, we'll take a look at this window controller, and this actually allows you to simulate the screen size or the browser size that would render this component. I can also control the window background, and the same thing I can do for the canvas. The canvas is here to simulate the parent component of the component that we're currently rendering. So if you know your component needs to render under certain constraints to behave a certain way or to look a certain way, then you can easily control that through here as well. You can also play around with alignments and margins and paddings and backgrounds of the canvas as well. And lastly, you have the option right at the top here of toggling this specific board to show in the Add Elements panel. This would make this fixture reusable so that you could later on add it into other bits of your application. Let's take a look at how that might appear. If we go back to our home screen, go back to our boards, and let's take a look at our main app for now. If I open up the Add panel and take a look at our components, I can already see those four icon components that we saw earlier on, ready to be added, each one with the props that we've set up specifically for that. If I go over and take a look at those, then you could see that I'm able to edit that that object, and to also provide it with a cover image. And here I can add an imported image, and that would actually appear in the rendered results within the Add panel instead of automatically rendering the component. So if you want to set up something very special, or you want to create a special design for the variants of your components, but you don't want it to actually be in the rendered output, then that's a way of doing so. Sometimes, however, components need a little bit of extra work in order to actually render. They might require a provider that gives them some data, or an external API call, or something of that sort. If we take a look again at our app component and take a peek down here at our code drawer, we can see that the app component has actually been wrapped with a provider that gives it the data that the app expects to receive. If we take a look at that app component, we can see that the consumer is within there, as you would expect to find it in the production code, and that would actually be used. So if you find yourself needing to set up something a little bit more complex for a board, you can do that easily within the board file. Now, that's not necessarily the end of it. Another option that you have is to set up what's called as a global board setup. If you find yourself constantly reusing the same setup and doing the same things in all of the boards, you can simply have Codux do it for you once. If we take a look at our files and we go over to our Codux config, then here we can see that we have the board global setup key already defined, and this sends us over to the SRC Codux boards global setup, and here we would actually find all sorts of SAS files that are being imported and provide context such as variables and so on to our application. So we don't have to import these into every single one of our boards. We can easily do so in one place and have that serve all of our use cases. I hope this video helped explain boards a little bit better, and that now you'll be able to go ahead and create brand new boards in your projects to simulate different props, screen sizes, and many different use cases. You can, of course, also create boards as reusable fixtures so that anyone could add them easily through the Add panel in your project. That's it for this one. Check out the video description for additional links and additional reading. See you next time. Bye-bye.